Hi, this is Jaya. In this video, we shall see the summary of Background Casually by Nazim Ezekiel. Come, let's go to the poem. Background Casually is actually an autobiographical poem by Nazim Ezekiel in which he talks about his own life. And this he has written in three sections. The first section, he tells about his childhood. Then in the second section, he talks about his adulthood. And in the third section, he talks about his old age. He does not only tell what is actually happening at that age, he also tells about his mental process during that age. Now come, we'll read the poem and see what he's saying. He starts the poem like this. A poet, rascal, clown was born. So he says, see, we all know that Nazim Ezekiel is a very famous poet. But he says that he was also a rascal and a clown. Clown means people around him had made fun of him, they have laughed at him. This is what he's trying to say through this. So he says, a poet, rascal, clown was born. The frightened child who would not eat or sleep, a boy of meager bone. And he says that when he was a child, he was so very frightened and he will not eat properly or he was not even able to sleep properly. And therefore, he was a very, very skinny boy. Meager bone means very thin boy. He never learned to fly a kite. His borrowed top refused to spin. And he said that when the same age group boys were experts in flying kite, he never even knew how to fly a kite. And at the same time, he did not have a own top. So this also explains his economical status when he was a child. And he says the borrowed top also will not spin when he spins it. So he was not very good in games also. And he was very frightened and he was very thin. These are the facts he tells so far. And then he says, I went to Roman Catholic school. And he had his schooling in a Roman Catholic school. And this may explain for his fluency in the language also. A mocking Jew among the wolves. Wolves here, he means the Muslim and Hindu boys who were along with him. And Nazim Ezekiel is a Jew. And they used to look at him as a mugging Jew. That is, he used to just mug up the potions. Maybe we can take that he was a very studious student also. And he says that all the other boys in his class were like wolves waiting to hunt him. They told me I had killed the Christ. See, he's a Jew. So they looked at him like Judas, as a representative of Judas. And they said that you are the one who killed Christ. That year, I won the scripture prize. But he says that that very same year, I won the prize for scripture. It shows how good he was in his studies. A Muslim sportsman boxed my ears. And he says that no one liked him and there was a Muslim boy who boxed him on his ears. I grew in terror of the strong but undernourished Hindu lads. And he says, I was always in fear and I was among these Hindu boys who were also undernourished. They were also from the same economical background. Their prepositions always wrong and he says that their language was not that good. Repelled me by passivity and they always repelled him. They made him feel so bad by their passiveness. They were not very friendly with him and they were always very cruel to him. One noisy day I used a knife and he says that went to that extent that one day he took the knife. But he does not explain any more further like what made him take the knife or what he did with the knife or really what happened. That is not explained in the poem. At home on Friday nights, the prayer was said. And he says, in our house, all Friday nights, we will do prayers. My morals had declined. And I started realizing that my morals were going down and down and down. I heard of yoga and of Zen. Could I perhaps be a Rabbi Saint? And then he started hearing about yoga and Zen. And he started wondering whether he will become a Rabbi Saint. The more I searched, the less I found. And he says that, so I started studying about all this, but it was only confusing. You should understand that he is a small boy. And he says, the more I started learning about that, the more and more I became confused. I was not able to find out anything from that. And then he goes to the next stage. He says, 22. He is now 22 years old. Time to go abroad. That is, his family wanted him to go to London for his higher education. First the decision, then a friend to pay the fare. So after deciding this, they found that they did not have that much money to spend for his education. But a friend came forward to spend for him. Philosophy, poverty and poetry. Three companions shared my basement room. And he said even there I did not have any friends. And he had because of the meager money which he had, he could only occupy a basement room, and his only three companions were philosophy, poverty and poetry. The London seasons passed me by. I lay in bed 2 years alone. And he says, for 2 years I was there and I was in London. I was just watching the seasons go by. Means he did not do anything fruitful in those years. And then a woman came to tell my willing ears, I was the son of man. And then he says, a woman came in my life and motivated me. I knew that I had failed in everything a bitter thought. And he understood that all along he had failed in everything, and that very thought itself brought bitterness to his mind. So in an English cargo ship, taking French guns and mortar shells to Indochina, scrubbed the decks and learned to laugh again at home. And so he wanted to come back to India, but he did not have the money to come back. So he worked in an English cargo ship, and he was taking French guns and mortar shells to Indochina, and he even did meager jobs like scrubbing the decks and all that for money, just to come back home and be with his family. How to feel at home was the point. But the thing is, he's a Jew. He's not an Indian. And how will he feel at home if he's in India? That was the main point. Some reading had been done, but what had I observed except my own exasperation? He's saying, okay, I tried to change, I tried to analyze the things, but it was of no use because all the people around us only looked at us as Jews. All Hindus are like that, my father used to say. When someone talked too loudly or knocked at the door, like the devil. And whatever happened is something which was really frightening him. And his father said, see, all Hindus are like that. They are always violent. And whenever he heard someone talking loudly or someone knocking at their door, that was all to bully them and to disgrace them. He was only in fear. They hawked and spat. And he says, that is not the end. They even hawked at him and they spat when they went around. They sprawled around. He's saying all around us, they were only people like this. I prepared for the worst. So I prepared my mind to face the worst. I knew that people are going to treat us only like this here. Married. Then I got married. Changed jobs. I did many jobs. And saw myself a fool. And I understood that I'm not doing anything right. I was doing something, but it was not the correct one. The song of my experience sung. And then I started writing poems using my experience. I knew that all was yet to sing, and then I understood there was so much more to write. My ancestors among the caste were aliens crushing seed for bread. The hooded bullock made his rounds. And he says, I am coming from a very economically backward class. And even my ancestors were only crushing seeds for bread. That is, they had to work very hard for their living. One among them fought and taught a major bearing British arms. And he says, of course, they were a few. Like one of them also was a part of the British Army. He told my father sad stories of the Boer War, and he has participated in many wars, and I've seen him telling about the Boer War to my father. I dreamed that fierce men had bound my feet and hands, and I understood that my hands and feet were tied, that even in my dream I used to get that illusion of fierce men coming and tying his hands and feet. The later dreams were all of words, but slowly, slowly my dreams started changing, and in my dreams I started seeing my poems. Words started coming in my dreams. I did not know that words betray, but let the poems come and lost that grip on things, the worldly price. He says that I did not know that words can cheat you. That is, it can take you away from the reality. And this poem, it made me to get away from the reality and live in my own world and feel happy. And I was able to forget about the things which were happening around me. I would not suffer that again. So now he is talking about his old age. He says, now I'm not going to suffer like how I suffered as a small boy or how I suffered even as an adult. I look about me now and try to formulate a plainer view. Now I'm able to look around me and I'm able to form a plain view with what is happening around me. The wise survive and serve to play the fool, to cash in on the inner and the outer storms. And he says, now I've understood that only the wise people can live here. And they can cash in on the inner and the outer storms. So whatever happens inside you and whatever happens outside you, that should not affect you. And if you are wise, you can suffer here. But if you are a fool, you cannot. The Indian landscape sears my ears. Now I'm looking at the Indian landscape.
I have become a part of it and I understood that now I've become a total Indian. To be observed by foreigners. The foreigners look at me as Indians, but Indians look at me as a alien. They say that I am singular. They let us overstate the case. And he says that everyone tells that I am the only one who is out. Like Indians look at me as foreigners and foreigners look at me as Indians. And so I am not fitted anywhere. I have made my commitments here, but I have decided I am going to be here. My commitments are here. My roots are here. This is one, to stay where I am. And what is my commitment is, I will stay where I am. As others choose to give themselves in some remote and backward place. And I know the other Jews are going off some way to a remote place or a backward place. My backward place is where I am. Thus ends the poem by saying that I am going to be here. This may be a backward place for me, but here I am. I am committed here. And India is my home. This is how he ends the poem. It's a very beautiful poem. If you have anything more to add on to this, please write it in the comment box. Like the video, share with your friends. And if you're not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Thank you.